Hey, hello everyone, welcome back to my channel. Hope everyone is doing good. If something is going to wrong, just let me know. I'll help you to get resolved in your project. Okay, so today no more discussions, directly jump to our main topic. So in this tutorial, you will gain a knowledge find client. Yes, so basically how to communicate among the microservices, these communications. So if you remember, in my last tutorial I have shown some diagrams and I have explained various component of Netflix, how you will use, right? So find client is one of the Netflix component which is used to communicate between the microservices. So let's say example, I have one microservices called employee consumer, right, and another microservices that is basically my employee producer. Okay, now I want to communicate from my employee consumer microservices to employee producer microservices. How we can achieve it? So normally we can achieve it REST template. Okay, you can see here we are using REST template, or we can place some MQ channel here, and then basically we can communicate, we can post this particular data in MQ channel, and this MQ channel basically return to that microservices. So like this way we can do these things. Okay, but with the help of find client we can easily resolve this issue. We need very less code and our communication should be perfect. And in this example I have used Eureka. It's nothing but our registry each of the microservices. Whenever any microservices wants to communicate with others microservices, that time they will get the details from the Eureka because they have registered their themselves. So I have totally three microservices: Eureka microservices, okay, that is for server, another is employee producer, another is employee consumer. So I want to call that employee producer microservices from employee consumer. So that is my intentions. So let me show quickly my programming part. So basically you can see here I have a employee consumer, this microservices is there, another is employee producer, and there in top there is a another microservices called my Eureka service. I'll show you. So one by one, so what I have implemented, first of all let me show my Eureka. So if you check in my Eureka microservice, nothing but what I did, I just use the simply @ enable Eureka server, right? So this annotations is enough, and in applications.properties file I only mentions like on which server port my this microservices will be running on. So this is my server, and if you talk about the my dependency part, only Netflix Eureka server, this dependency is enough to create your Eureka server. So if you check my applications file, nothing I have written. So this is my Eureka server, okay, and second thing is my producer. So in my producer, if you talk about that applications.properties file, first of all I have mentioned that on which port my application should be run, and also what would be my instance ID when it would be actually registered in Eureka. So this is a Eureka switch, okay, and also on which URL Eureka is running. So that is means on which URL my this microservice will be registered. So that is actually Eureka URL. So I have given nothing but a 8090 on which port my Eureka is running. So by default port, if you not mentions in Eureka, so it will running 8671. Okay, and if you talking about bootstrap dot properties file, only I have mentions my this microservice name. So this is important. So while you will communicate with others microservices through find client, and I have a simple model class. So this model class is nothing but a employee model class. So you can see this is a simple employee model class, and also I have a one controller class. So controller class, what I am actually adding employee ID, employee name, and salary, some other details. Okay, and this is my URL. So this is basically simple controller class. Now if you talk about my main applications class of this microservices, so I have actually used extra annotations, that is at the rate enable discovery client. So it's nothing but like it will actually register in that Eureka server. So whenever any microservice wants to register to the Eureka server, that time you have to provide this configurations URL in that applications properties file, what I have shown, and also you need to annotate this main class with @enableDiscoveryClient. So that is my producer. So producer is basically returning one employee details. So if you talk about my consumer, okay, so consumer main is important. So I just want to show one small things in my pom.xml of my producer microservices. So producer microservices, I don't need Eureka server this dependency, because this is not a server, this will act as a Eureka client. So I have only mentions Eureka client, and ribbon is there. So if you don't want you just don't need to mention it. And also there is a open fine, so it's not need to mention here, because here we will not call the microservice consumer. So we'll call this producer microservice from consumer. So this particular dependency is needed in my consumer microservices. So let me quickly show my consumer microservice pom. So you can see, so there is a also Eureka client is there, because it will also register Eureka server, and also ribbon and open fine. So this is basically fine client dependency. So here it is needed, because this microservice will talk to the employee microservices, but employee microservice producer microservices, it's not needed. So I have added just template, so for your understanding purpose, but if you don't, no need to mention it. And also if you don't want, you just remove that ribbon part. Okay, and now let me show my applications.properties file. Similarly, I have mentions here on which server port it is running, and also I have mentions like Eureka that URL, so localhost and 8090, but here I didn't mention that Eureka instance ID. If you want, you can mention, but it's not a important parameters, but two parameters is needed. And if you talking about bootstrap.properties file, similarly like my employee producer, I have mentions it here, employee consumer. Now we'll show the model class. So similar model class actually you need to copy here, because you need to actually retype some information. So you need that model class definitions, or else this model class should not be reflected here. Okay, so unless until if you are using some JSON response, so that time you can use that map or something, so that is a generic. But if you are retyping any model, so from others microservices, you need to place it in your code. So just keep it in your mind. And now, so what I need to do? So main things I need to do, I need to create one interface. So that interface basically interact with the producer employee producer microservices, you can see. Okay, so this is a interface, you can give any name, but this interface should be annotated with @findClient. So that is nothing but your actually remote call service. Okay, this is actually you are calling from this microservice to that employee producer. So you have to make one interface in that microservice, and you have to annotate with @findClient, and name should be same as what you have mentions in bootstrap.properties file of that microservice which you are going to call. So that is means employee hyphen producer, you can see same thing is mentioned. So based on that, it will call from the it will check from the discovery service, nothing but a Eureka registry, and it will call. And then you have to use what you are actually calling. You are actually calling get method. If you check this test controller, this is a request mapping, so nothing but a by default get method. So you have to mentions like a similar. So here I have a mentions get method, and I have provided only URL is needed. So now whatever you actually need, I mean, you can give this name as per your wish. There is a no restrictions, but return type should be same. So if you check here, return type is employee, and also here return type is employee. So only this signature is needed. So but method name you can give as your wish, only this signature and this annotations, and along with that service name, right? And second things, what you need to do, you need to annotate this main class like @ find clients, right? I think you got it. And also I forget to here actually mentions @ discovery client, so that it will also register my Eureka server. And here if you talk about my consumer controller client, so this is my final client, so controller. So from there actually I want to retype the informations. So whatever configurations I done in find call service, so that is only configurations is needed and main class. And now I want to call this method, so simply I'll auto add this my find client call service, so it's nothing but that interface. And then I'll create a simple method, okay? So you don't need to provide any URL. So now you can see load balancer dot get data. So now I am printing the employee get data here. So now you can see, right? So let me run first of all my Eureka service. I hope, I mean, your confusions has been clear. So if still do you think like you have some confusions here, just make a comments in the comment sections. So already I have started my Eureka server applications, so it will take some times. And also I'll start my producer, okay? So two console will be running at the same time, so it would be very difficult to understand which console it is. But don't worry, here I show the name. This is a Eureka server applications, you can see, and this is a Spring Boot Hello World applications, is nothing but your employee producer. But definitely I'll start this employee consumer microservice in my console so that you can understand in my CMD console, okay? So let me check with the URL. So already you can see I have opened this one, my Eureka, so it's running on 8090. Let me hit this one, okay? So still it's not up yet, I guess. So that's what it is giving this no response. Yes, it's going up, I guess. Yes, it was taking actually some times. It's up now. So now you can see no instances is available. Let me refresh, because by that time, yes, you can see my employee producer, these instances is up. So till now I didn't up my consumer service, right? So let me up this one. So I am running it from my console, okay? So I have already created this jar, and let me run my jar. This is the syntax, java space minus jar space that your jar name. So you can see this is a employee consumer jar. So it will take some times, just be patient. So you can see already that web applications initializations done, and then it will try to register with the Eureka, because we have provided the URL. You can see initializing Eureka in region US East 1. And now it will actually up within 2 to 4 seconds, I think. Already discovery client, this part is done. Now it is actually starting. Let's wait. So in the meantime, let's see whether my applications will show here or not. Employee consumer, not yet, it's showing. It's taking time. Okay, now it's successfully up and my application successfully started. Okay, so first of all, I'll show in my localhost Eureka. So you can see employee consumer also up here, right? And now if you go here in the console, you can clearly see the response. Okay, so you can see this is the ID, it's nothing but a, and this is the employee ID from producer one. So what was in my code? So my code is there exactly same employee ID from producer express clone, and then I was actually trying to retrieve that employee ID. You can see same things I am getting here in the console. So this is actually this is how we can communicate among the microservices. So instead of using REST template or any MQ channel with the fine client, only few configurations is needed. Let me summarize this one. Only you need to create one interface with the annotations of @ fine client. You have to provide that microservices name from which you are want to extract that information, and then you have to provide the signature here, and then with just you need to auto add in your applications, and you can call that respective method. And I talked about whatever the model class you will using while retrieving the data, same model class you have to put it unless until it would be JSON. And third point, what I said, you have to mark your main class with @ enable fine clients. So successfully we have actually represent how to call from one microservice to another microservice, how this communication is happening with the help of Netflix fine client. Enjoyed this video. Still, if you have a doubt, just make a comments. I'll provide the resolutions. And as usual, you will get the link in the description sections of my GitHub. You can download these three code in your locally, and you can run and you can try yourself. Thanks for watching my video. I'll see you in next tutorial. Bye.